This right here is one of my welders. This is a little Hobart Handler 140 MIG welder. It'll do inner shield, flux core, or you can connect a gas bottle and run solid MIG wire. Now, I've had this thing for a long time. It's been a great little welder, but I'm going to do something really stupid. You see, the Suzuki lower units that I've done a video on have started having a new problem where the drive shaft breaks off inside of the housing so far down in that there's no way to extract it. So I've come up with an idea that I'm going to weld a nut or a long coupling nut to the top of the drive shaft so I can pull it out with a slide hammer. But the problem is it's about a foot down in there, and yeah, my MIG gun here, Stinger, whatever you want to call it, is not a foot long. What would stop me from taking some brake line, two tips, and kind of putting this into there and brazing a tip in so that then I could have the wire come out of here and then have brake line brazed onto that out, and then have another tip at the end just so that it guides the wire through the brake line nice and smooth. I should note, I'm not a professional welder. I really have no idea what I'm doing. If you are a professional welder and you know how bad of an idea this is, go down in the comments right now and tell me how bad of an idea this is. But I've got bad news. If you're seeing this video, I've already done it, tried it, and so after you're done writing your comment telling me how horrible of an idea this is, come back up so you can watch me find out that you were right. I wonder if that's going to pinch that, make it not work. Let's see if I can set fire to these boxes. Look at that. How hot did this end get? Not bad at all. All right, turn it around, solder this end on. See my wire up here? If this isn't the most glorious thing you've ever seen, well, you're on the wrong channel, because this is probably really stupid. But I never said I was smart, in my defense. So, I guess we're going to see what's going to happen here. So I've got some threaded rod and a coupling nut. And my plan is stick this down in there and use this to weld the coupling nut to the stub end of the drive shaft that's broke off, and then attach this to a slide hammer and yank it out. So I have no idea if it's gonna work, but let's find out. Can't really tell what I'm welding on. Can't see down in there because it's dark. How much you want to bet that this just rips this thing off first pull? Yeah. Trying to run away on me though. Ah, there it went. Oh! No way! No way! I can rebuild this lower unit now. And while I think my ultimate Weldifier 9000 needs a little bit more tweaking, it works. It didn't blow up. So if you told me what I was doing wrong, you're too late. Wait, no. I don't know how that all works. But anyways, that's all for now. Thanks for watching.